This presentation deals with the analysis of the experimental and the numerical behavior of lattice structure produced through additive manufacturing processes. My name is Andrea Tredello and I am a researcher at the Politecnico di Torino. This research has been carried out in collaboration with the society Altair, leader in simulation-driven design. In the last years, the research on the mechanical behavior of lattice structures has gained significant attention. Indeed, components made of lattice structure can be hardly produced with traditional manufacturing processes, but the development of AM process, on the other hand, has made it possible their production and their diffusion. Lattice structures are defined as a three-dimensional structure composed of interconnected cells. Each cell is composed by structs and nodes, as shown in this slide. Cell geometry, as well as the cell parameters, like the struct diameter, the cell size, significantly affect the mechanical properties of the final component or specimen. These parameters, shown in red in this figure, can be optimized to obtain the required mechanical properties, depending on the application. In this slide, some applications of lattice structure are shown. In this activity, I will focus on the energy absorption applications. The activities described in this presentation are part of a large project whose main objective is the design of a crash box made of lattice structure with high energy absorption. At this conference, I will focus on the activities involved, the experimental assessment of the cell with the highest energy absorption capabilities, the simulation of the lattice experimental response, static, quasi-static, as well as dynamic due to impact loads. These goals are pursued with the following steps. At first, the cell with the highest absorption capabilities is assessed through quasi-static compressive tests on lattice structure specimen made of carbon nylon. Thereafter, compressive tests are simulated by using 1D elements to obtain the solution in a limited tested time, without a loss of accuracy. Through this step, the 1D model is tuned. The third step, compression, quasi-static and impact test on aluminium silicon 10 magnesium specimen, the material that probably will be used for the crash box, will be carried out. Finally, the finite element model developed for tests on carbon nylon specimen is used for simulating the experimental response of aluminium silicon 10 magnesium alloy specimens under compression, static as well as dynamic impact loads. For the assessment of the cell with the highest absorption capability, 5 lattice cells are compared. They have been selected from the literature papers and from a numerical study carried out in Altair. In order to compare the mechanical response of the cells, they have been produced with a carbon nylon filament with a 3D printing system available at the D-Lab at the Politecnico di Torino. In particular, the Ultimaker 5S printer was used with an FDM technique. 3 cells each side were considered for the specimens in order to induce a pure compression failure according to the literature. More details on the specimen can be found in this slide. The compression tests were carried out with a standard tensile testing machine. By imposing a crosshead displacement of 1 mm per minute, the specimen was also recorded during the test by using a dynalized microscope in order to verify the failure mode, and for each specimen geometry, 2 repetitions were considered. In this slide, the acquired force displacement response obtained by testing each specimen geometry is plotted. The first test is shown, since the scatter between the 2 tests was not so large, and the trend was the same. As can be seen in the figure, the cell geometry strongly influenced the compression response with very large differences. For example, all the specimens show 3 peaks and 3 valleys in the plastic region. These valleys indeed correspond to the failure of 1 layer of cell. For the cell 8, this behavior is less pronounced. The cell number 4 shows the best behavior. However, for a proper comparison, different parameters like the peak force, the total absorbed energy, and the specific energy absorption should be compared. In this slide, the peak force, the absorbed energy, and the specific energy absorption are compared. According to the figure, the cell allowing for the highest energy absorption and the highest SEA is the cell number 4, which therefore has been selected and considered as the most appropriate for energy absorption applications. The experimental results obtained in this first part of the activity have been used for the validation and the calibration of a finite element model. The simulation of the behavior of parts made of lattice structure is not simple. Indeed, in order to model the struts and the nodes, a large number of elements should be used due to the small diameter of the structs, increasing the computation time. On the other hand, too simple or approximated model could not be capable to properly simulate the real behavior of the material. In this work, the selected specimen has been simulated by using 1D beam elements according to the Timoshenko theory for the material properties, and elastoplastic behavior was considered, and the real curve in the plastic range was inserted point by point. Moreover, the contact between beams was also simulated. In this figure, details on the model can be found. In this slide, the experimental and numerical results are analyzed and reported. In particular, the force displacement curve, the failure modes, and the absorbed energy are compared. By considering the force displacement curve in the elastic region, the two curves are very close. And the peak force obtained experimentally and numerically are similar, with the finite element curve between the two experimental curves. For the plastic region, the numerical curve is close to the experimental curves. In particular, the failure of the first and the third layer found experimentally and numerically occur at the same displacement and peak force, whereas in the simulated curve, a net failure of the second layer is not evident. However, the differences between the peak force, the absorbed energy, and the stray energy absorption are limited, being less than 9% for the peak force and very limited, less than 3% for the absorbed energy and the specific absorbed energy, which are fundamental parameters in impact tests. Moreover, by comparing the video recorded experimentally and the one obtained through simulation, it is clear that the failure mode is the same, with the lower layer failing first. This analysis confirms that 1D model can be exploited to accurately simulate the compressive response of lattice structure in a limited testing time, about 10 minutes, with results very close to the experimental one. For example, with 3D elements, the same simulation lasts more than 80 hours. Compression quasi-static tests were thereafter carried out on lattice structure specimen in aluminium silicon tank magnesium alloy, which is the material that will probably be used for the crash box. The specimens were produced through a selective laser melting process with industrial optimized parameters. The cell geometry was the one selected in previous analysis, and the same testing configuration and equipment was considered. This figure, the force displacement curve for the two tests are reported. The three peaks and valleys corresponding to the layer failures were not found, with a drastic drop displacement after the peak. This experimental curve, therefore, suggests that a different failure mode occurred for this material. Indeed, by analyzing the recorded video, the specimens failed at 45 degrees, as shown in this slide. This, according to the literature, could be maybe due to the different stiffness of the cell and the interaction between the cell and the material. According to this experimental evidence, a failure mode called failure plastic strain, indicating the plastic strain energy at which 1D element fails, has been added to the model. In this figure, the numerical force displacement curve with the failure mode is plotted together with the experimental force displacement curve. The elastic region is still in agreement with the experimental curve, and also the plastic region with the failure mode capable to simulate efficiently the cell failure. With this failure mode, the elements are deleted, and this justifies the rapid drop of the numerical curve. However, the decrement trend is very close and very similar. The energy with respect to the displacement curve, plotted in this slide, numerical and experimental, further confirm the model effectiveness and the proper choice of the parameter for simulating the behavior of the lattice structure in aluminium alloy. Finally, impact tests on the same aluminium alloy specimen used for quasi-static compression tests were carried out. In this figure, the drop dart testing machine used for the test is shown, with magnification of the clamping system designed for blocking the specimen and of the impactor. In this slide, the impact tests carried out at about 2 meters per second are reported. In particular, the force displacement curves are shown. The two curves are close to each other, showing a good repeatability, proving, therefore, the effectiveness of the manufacturing process. In this slide, the force displacement curve of the impact test carried out at about 3 meters per second are shown. Even in this case, the two curves are close to each other. More interesting is the graph shown in this figure, which plots the force displacement curves for the quasi-static and the impact test. According to the figure, strain rate effect is clear, with the maximum force increasing with the impact speed. Moreover, for the impact test, the maximum displacement decreases with the impact speed. This effect must be taken into account when the impact test is simulated. Also in this case, the failure occurs at 45 degrees, with limited energy absorption. Therefore, non-strain rate effect associated to the failure mode was experimentally observed. Thereafter, the impact response of the lattice structure has been simulated by using the Altair suite and the solver radios, starting from the model used for simulating the quasi-static compression test. The impactor has been modeled with a rigid plate with the same experimental mass and speed. The base plate, on the other hand, has been modeled with 2D elements to properly simulate the densification. Moreover, in order to properly model the strain rate effect, a first simple model implemented in the material curve has been considered. This model involves to shift the quasi-static curve by a scale factor multiplied by the strain rate computed experimentally. The image shown in this slide clarifies the model used. In this slide, the experimental validation of the finite element model is reported. In the first and the second figure, the force displacement curves of the impact test at 2 and 3 meters per second are shown. In both cases, the models are in agreement with the experimental data, even if some differences are clear. For example, for the smallest impact speed, the peak force is similar, whereas at higher impact speed, there is a not negligible difference. Moreover, the model is not capable to properly model the gradual layer failure with a force decrement to zero after the peak. The reason is related to the failure mode considered in this presentation. Indeed, when the deformation energy is associated to an element reach the threshold value, selected threshold value, the element is deleted. Therefore, it is not capable to bear anymore the applied loads with the behavior shown in the figure and the rapid drop of the force. Therefore, the material model considered for strain rate effect is very simple and easy to implement, but a simple shift of the quasi-static curve is not capable to properly model the strain rate dependence, and more complex model, depending on the application, may be suggested. On the other hand, the finite element energy displacement curve are close to the experimental curve, with limited differences on the maximum energy, regardless of the impact speed. Therefore, it can be concluded that the proposed model with 1D element and with its simple simulation for strain rate can reliably be used to assess the stored energy, whereas it is less accurate to model the force displacement curve. To conclude, very briefly, the response of specimen made of lattice structure has been investigated numerically and experimentally in this work. Experimental compression tests on carbon nylon specimens to assess the cell ensuring the highest absorption capability under compression loads and to calibrate the finite element model of the specimen with 1D elements have been carried out. The same tests were carried out on aluminium silicon tank magnesium specimen for which a different failure mode was found. The test was also simulated, different from the carbon nylon. The model was found to be in agreement only if a failure mode is considered, due to the influence of the cell stiffness and of the failure mode. Impact tests were finally carried out on the aluminium alloy specimen by considering two impact speed. A significant strain rate effect was experimentally found. The numerical model was found to be in agreement by considering the energy displacement curve with limited differences. On the other hand, larger differences were found for the force displacement curve, mainly related to the simple model considered for the strain rate effect. According to these results and analysis, when the elements can be reliably used to simulate the lattice structure behavior, but an experimental validation is recommended and suggested. Thank you for your kind attention.